glory. Hallelujah. Since I laid my burdens down. Somebody today may be carrying around some heavy burdens. And I encourage you today to just lay them down at the feet of the Lord. Hallelujah. What I'm going to do now is go ahead and get my scripture out of the way. So today we're going to be in Isaiah chapter 43. And the verses is going to be 15 and 16. So again, it's Isaiah 43, verses 15 and 16. Those verses read, I am the Lord, your Holy One, the Creator of Israel, your King. Thus saith the Lord, which maketh a way in the sea and a path in the mighty waters. The word of God for the people of God. What we're going to do right now is we're going to go ahead and have another song selection by this wonderful praise team. Of the Lord, because God is a way maker. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, I call upon your holy and most precious name, God. First and foremost, just wanting to say thank you. God, thank you for waking us up this morning. God, thank you for breathing breath into our bodies. Lord, Lord God, thank you for watching over us, protecting us, and keeping us. Lord God, thank you for giving us safe traveling mercies. Lord God, and in all that's been going on, Lord God, we just want to say thank you for being with us and for keeping us safe, Lord God. Heavenly Father, we just ask right now, Lord God, that you just look within us. If there's anything that's within us that's not of you, Lord God, we ask that you remove it, that nothing hinders us from you. Heavenly Father, right now, I pray that you speak to my spirit, that you anoint me afresh, Lord God, to preach your word, Lord God, in season and out of season. Lord God, I pray when they see me, Lord God, they don't see me, but they see you. I bow down to you, God. I decrease that you may increase. Lord God, have your way in this place on this day. In Jesus' most holy and precious name, I pray. Amen. 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 So right now, as we all know, we are truly enduring a season where the waters are raging, the road is rough, and the journey ahead will truly be tough. Some may even notice that there are moments where your countenance is down, anxiety and spells of depression is trying to get the best of you, and you feel yourself feeling like we are battling a hopeless situation. Your mind is taking you to a place where you wonder, are we ever going to recover from the way things are now? Are things ever going to be made right again? And then you say, Lord, how are we going to climb out of this pit of chaos and despair? Some may be wondering, is this going to be the way it's going to be going forward? Is this indeed, God, the new normal that we are going to have to become accustomed to? And this COVID-19 pandemic, these vigilante actions and police brutality, among other things, has produced the fear that has some folk confined to their homes and afraid to even go outdoors into the sunlight and breathe in the fresh air that God has provided for us. That fear has crept in and has people suffering in silence and on the verge of losing their minds, battling with anxiety, depression, cabin fever, grief, financial strife, and sickness, amongst other things. But my brothers and sisters, I am here to encourage you on today that no matter what we are facing today and what we may have to go through on tomorrow or the days to come, that God is a way maker. This is the topic I want to speak on today. God is a way maker. And if I was to tag my text with the subtopic, the title would be, Say His Name. So my sermon text comes from Isaiah chapter 43, verses 15 and 16 again, which says, I am the Lord, your Holy One, the Creator of Israel, your King. Thus said the Lord, which maketh a way in the sea and a path in the mighty waters. And so during this time in the scripture, the prophet Isaiah foresaw a time of great difficulty for the Israelites. He saw a time when they would be captured and held in exile by their Babylonian enemies. Their homes would be destroyed. Their place of worship would be destroyed. And their days of exile became years, years, and years in which the people began to question in their hearts if the situation they were in was hopeless, if there was indeed ever going to be a way out of the difficult time. And their faith was wavering as they were reaching their breaking point. Perhaps some of you are near that point now. You feel you are at your breaking point and just can't take it anymore. You may be filled up to full capacity and at your wit's end, but how many of you know that God is always on time? In the scripture, God spoke to the people and reminded them who he was to them. He reminded them who he has always been to them. God took the time and their time of need to reintroduce himself. God said to the people, I am the Lord, your Holy One, the Creator of Israel, and your King. In other words, God was saying, I am the great I am. I am the one who created you, and you are mine. And although you are suffering now by the hands and actions of this earthly king with the little k of Babylonia, I am the big king, and I am still on the throne. That is good news for somebody somebody today who is worried about what is going on in our country and with the leader in the White House right now who thinks that he is on the throne. He may have forgotten that at any given moment he can be dethroned by the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You see, there is only one King, one Master, and one Creator, and in time, all will recognize and see him for who he is, who he has always been, and who he will always be. So again, God reminded his downtrodden children that it was he who made a way through the sea and a path through the mighty waters. This took them back to their journey through the Red Sea. You all remember how the children of Israel had left Egypt and how Pharaoh's heart was hardened and he came after them with hundreds upon hundreds of soldiers and chariots. And they approached the children of Israel who looked before them and they saw they didn't have anywhere to go. They looked behind them and they saw that they didn't have nowhere to go. And they looked on both sides and realized they had nowhere to go. And so they were trapped. At least that's what they thought. But how many of you know that God is a way maker? How many of you know that God is still in the miracle working business? How many of you know that God is the keeper of his promises? Therefore, for those of you who are feeling lost, those of you who are feeling weary, and if you're out of options in this season, let me encourage you with a scripture found a little bit down further in this text. In Isaiah chapter 43, verse 13, God says, "For I am about to do something new. See, I have already begun. Do you not see it? I will make a pathway through the wilderness. I will create rivers in the dry wasteland." So you see, the way we see things that we view now with the naked eye does not possibly see what God is doing behind the scenes. But he is doing a new thing in this season. You see, it was time to break up the nest of our comfortability and stagnance. It was time to break down our idols and the things that was pulling us from God. And it was time to shake things up so that we can really see. God says, "Sit still, my brothers and sisters. Wait, watch, and pray, and you will see that God is doing a new thing. For he is indeed our waymaker. He has made a way time and time again when there was no possibility of formulating a way by human power or reasoning." So let me utilize the scriptures to prove my case that God is a way maker.
Come on, preacher.
Didn't God make a way when he parted the Red Sea so that Moses and the children of Israel could cross over on dry land to escape the Egyptian army who thought they had them trapped? Didn't God make a way when he rescued Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego from being burned to death after being thrown in the fiery furnace? Oh yes, God made a way when he shut up the mouth of the vicious lions so they could not harm Daniel when he was thrown in the lion's den and had to stay there all night long. God made a way when he shook the foundation of the prison walls that Paul and Silas were locked up in, opening the doors and breaking the chains that held them bound, yet setting them free. Oh yes, my brothers and sisters, God made a way when Jesus spoke to the raging wind and the waves and they ceased immediately. I tell you, our God is a way maker. Didn't Jesus feed 5,000 souls with only two fish and five loaves of bread, all the while having an abundance of food left over? Didn't Jesus raise the dead man Lazarus? Didn't he heal the lepers, give a voice to the mute? Didn't Jesus open the eyes of the blind, healed and strengthened the limbs of the paralyzed? Didn't Jesus put the possessed man in his right mind? Didn't Jesus make the woman who had an issue of blood whole and even more? So why don't you say his name? Jesus is our way maker. Say his name. Jesus is our miracle worker. Say his name.
Jesus
is our promise keeper. Come on and say his name. Jesus is our light in the darkness. Say his name. Jesus is our hope for today and tomorrow. Say his name. Jesus is our ultimate provider. What's his name?
Jesus.
Jesus. Say his name. Jesus is our strength, our shield and buckler. Say
deliverer and healer. Come on, somebody. Say his name.
Jesus
is our Lord and Savior. Say his name. Jesus is our vindicator and protector. Say his name. Jesus is our power source and our rejuvenator. Say his name. Jesus is our heart fixer and mind regulator. Say his name. Jesus is our comforter and friend. Say his name. Jesus is the supplier of every need. What's his name? His name is Jesus. Say his name. Jesus is the changer of our circumstances. Say his name. Jesus is our lawyer in the courtroom and our defender against our enemy. Say his name. Jesus is our surgeon in the operating room. Say his name. Jesus is our waymaker in the midnight hour. Say his name. Jesus is the one who captures and dries all of our tears. Say his name. Jesus is the healer of our body and the rescuer of our soul. So what is his name? His name is Jesus. What's his name? His name is Jesus. What's his name? His name is Jesus. Say his name. Say his name. Say his name. Jesus is our justifier. Jesus is our all in all. Jesus is our everything. So my brothers and sisters, be encouraged that although things don't seem as they should, and things are not as they were, that God is a waymaker and he is doing a new thing. None of us should come through these forms of life the same way that we went into them. When the church doors reopen, no one will be able to sit and observe and not praise God, our waymaker, for bringing us through. When vindication come out in these streets, no one will be able to thank God and to say the name that's above all names. His name is Jesus. And the scriptures in Philippians reminds us of what shall happen at the sound of the name of Jesus. Philippians 2, 9 through 11 says, wherefore God also hath highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee shall bow, of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. So I tell you the truth, even those who refuse to say the name now, one day is coming where we will all say the name. What's his name? His name is Jesus, our way maker. What's his name? His name is Jesus, our miracle worker. What's his name? His name is Jesus, our promise keeper. What's his name? His name is Jesus, our light in the darkness. What's his name? His name is Jesus, our way maker. God will make a way when it seems to be no way. So don't give up and don't give in this season. Don't let depression get the best of you, knowing that Jesus is our way maker. Don't let anxiety and fear get the best of you, knowing that God is our way maker. Don't let anything stand in the way, because God is our way maker. Whatever you stand in need of, God will provide it. Jesus is our way maker. The doors of the church are open.
That's all right.
Maybe someone at the sound of my voice right now, you're struggling. Right now, you don't even know if you're coming or going. Right now, fear is so bubbled up inside that you can't even think straight. Right now, if that's you, I'm talking to you. God wants you to know that everything is going to be okay. We don't know, but God knows all things. So all we can do is step out in faith and stand on the promises of God. God loves for us to speak his word back to him. God likes for us to remind him of what he promised us. So just speak to the Lord. Just calm down your spirit and just cry out to the Lord. the one that hears all things, the one that sees all things. When people come and go, God will still be there. Late in the midnight hours, God will still be right there. God has not left us and he has not forsaken us. Even though we don't understand everything that's going on in this season, it seems like we're being hit from the left and the right, from the front and the back. But God says that I'm with you and I'll be with you always, even until the end of the earth. Maybe there's someone right now that has not accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior. This is your opportunity, wherever you are, to cry out to the Lord and to ask Jesus to come into your life. All you have to say is Jesus. Just call out on the name of Jesus. Jesus, I know that I'm a sinner. I know, God, that I'm lost. But I know that you sent your son Jesus to die for me. I know that Jesus bled, suffered, and died for me. That he died, was buried, and that he rose again on the third day with all power in his hands. I confess Jesus as my Lord and Savior. Come into my life. Save me and make me whole. If you said that, look for it. The angels in heaven are rejoicing. Welcome to the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. 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 After this praise team, sing the selection. We'll close with the benediction. Now and forevermore. Amen. Go in peace.